I made.
Let's pack an $85 order for Trina. Trina ordered 14 items from my shop, and I also threw in a full-size soap freebie for her because I'm doing a deal on my website right now where if you spend over $40 in my shop, then you automatically get a free soap. Trina got 7 full-size bars of soap in Fresh Start, Vanilla Rose, Sage and Beige, Cocoa Cashmere, Driftwood, Rosemary Mint, and Lavender Bliss, and I threw in a frosted fur soap for her. And then she also got 2 mini Driftwood soaps, 2 mini Fresh Start soaps, 2 mini oatmeal and honey soaps, and a mini eucalyptus mint soap. And I actually ran out of medium-sized boxes, so I just cut this one to size. This is what I do whenever I run out. And I feel like it works pretty well. And then I just closed everything up with some tape and a personalized name sticker on the outside of the box. Thank you so much, Trina, for all your support. I hope you love everything you ordered.
Let's pack Rebecca's soap order. So she got 4 bars of vanilla birthday cake soap and 2 bars of iced cinnamon roll, as well as 2 bars of fairy fountain. She also decided to get a bar of my sugar cookie soap and coconut milk in roses, as well as 2 bars from my crystal collection, which is love spell and patchouli rose quartz. She also got one of my brown sugar and fig soaps, along with a water lily and jasmine soap and 2 solid perfumes. To her order, I decided to add a free gift of vanilla bourbon soap and these really cute stickers that I hope she would like, just as a way to say thank you so much for supporting me. I really appreciate it, Rebecca, and I hope you love everything that you're getting. Thanks again.
This is my attempt at making a Princess and the Frog soap, and I decided to make it with a swirl of purple, green, and gold, along with these cute little frog molds, and then some crowns on top, some golden crowns. So I tried this new technique where I poured all of the colors in at the same time, which was really, really difficult because I only have 2 hands, of course, and so I had to hold 2 of the pitchers with 1 hand by like the rim. It was really, really difficult. And I scented it with honey, like her beignets.
I'll be fucked up if you can't be right. Yeah. I do the same thing I told you that I never would. I told you I changed, even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay, need you to stay. Yeah. I do the same thing I told you that I never would. I told you I changed. Your touch, you're the reason I believe in love. It's been difficult for me to trust, and I'm afraid that I'ma fuck it up in a way that I can leave you stranded, cause you ain't never left me empty handed, and you know that I know that I can't live without you, so baby stay.
Hey everyone, today I'm making some brand new Pop-Tart wax melts, but before I show you the ones I'm making today, I want to go back and show you this clip of how I created the silicone mold using real Pop-Tarts. So first I place those Pop-Tarts in my container, and then I mix up my silicone mixture. And then I pour my silicone all over the Pop-Tarts. And then I let that sit for about a day, and then it's time to unmold. And then this is my new mold. I then clean out all the cavities, take it over to the sink and wash it out. And then I cut all of these Pop-Tart cavities into separate pieces so they're easier to unmold. And then I start pouring my wax. So now I'm pouring the wax for today's wax melts. First I'm pouring some icing. I did want my icing to be a little bit more white. but the fragrance I'm using is blueberry cobbler, and it has a yellow tint to it, so there's no way to make the icing completely white. Next, I am pouring in a little bit of my blue gel wax. The stuff is super, super sticky, very messy. And then I pour my crust colored wax on top. These are all scented in a blueberry cobbler fragrance. Next, it's time to unmold, and this is what they look like so far. And of course, I have multicolored sprinkles to sprinkle on top of these Pop-Tarts. But first, I'm going to melt the very tops of the icing with my heat gun, and then I'm going to sprinkle those sprinkles on top of the Pop-Tarts. These get packaged back to back, so you'll receive two per order. And these also get packaged in my window boxes. And if you're wondering what the inside of these Pop-Tarts looks like, I'm going to break one apart here and show you how jelly-like the center is. These will be available in my next release, which is Friday, February 24th at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific Time. Thank you so much for watching.
How people think I started.
Somewhere far away.
Versus the reality.